things of God are not left here. Let's pray that God will make him gold. Even in any fire that he passes through, God will take him higher. In the name of Jesus. Let's pray for the people that are coming before him. The worship session, the open heaven, the hymn. Let's pray that the hand of the Lord will be mightier upon all of them. Whenever we hear from them, we shall be on a greater pedestal. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. If you are glad to be alive, on a day like this, rise to your feet and shout hallelujah. Don't wave your hand to him and just say, Father, thank you for the gift of life. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I am grateful. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything you have done. Thank you, Jesus.
Plantation of disappointment, evil plantation of failure, every
me. Make an expressway for me. In the name of Jesus. He said he will make way even in the wilderness. He will make way in the wilderness. In the forest, there will be expressway for you. Make way for me. Thank the Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. In the book of Proverbs chapter 21, verse 1. Proverbs 21 verse 1. The Bible says that the heart of kings, they are in whose hand? Yes. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord. As the rivers of water, he turneth it whithersoever he will. He will will to turn the king's heart in your life to favor you. He will will to turn the king's heart to uplift you. You. Open your hand and pray and say, Father, anyone in the position of a king in my life, touch the heart to favor me, to bless me, to honor me, to advance me positively. Anyone in the position of a king in my life, in whatever area, touch some special heart. Bless them, your lady. In Jesus' mighty name, we are free. How excellent is your name. Place. In the book of Joshua chapter 5 verse 12, Joshua chapter 5 verse 12, it was the time that they got to the promised land that the manna ceased. And the manna ceased. On the morrow, after they had eaten of the whole corn of the land, neither had the children of Israel manna anymore. But they did eat of the fruit of the land. Okay now, that's it. Whenever supplies stops from a particular quarter, it does not mean that the goodness of God has stopped. It just means that God is redirecting you to another place of supply. Concerning Elijah, the brook stopped giving water and the raven stopped. But the supply did not stop. God told him, now go to a window that I've already prepared to feed you. And I believe that the meal that the widow will be cooking, it will be better than the one, the cake that is being brought. So God is trying to take somebody to a better place. But it may appear as if, why are these supplies up? In the book of 1 Kings chapter 17, 6 to 9. 1 Kings 17, 6 to 9. Talking about Elijah. When the brook stopped giving water, and the raven stopped, and the raven brought him bread and flesh in the morning, and bread and flesh in the evening, and he drank of the brook. And it came to pass after a while that the brook dried up, because there had been no rain in the land. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, the word of the Lord will locate you. Arise, get thee to Zelophehad, which belongeth to Zidon, and dwell there. Behold, I have commanded, it was a command, a widow woman there to sustain thee. So my prayer is, any time that supply has stopped from a particular quarter in my life, Lord, lead me to the next point of supply. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, in any area of my life that supply has stopped, lead me to the next and better place of supply. Lead me, Lord. Lead me to the next and better place of supply. Lead me to the next and better place. better place of supply. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Sometimes, when people are in battle, they need support. Nobody goes to the battle all alone. But if the support that you need gets withdrawn from you, you are vulnerable. That was how Uriah in David's army was killed. David wrote a letter, even though he was the one that submitted the letter to Joab. And David wrote in that letter, take him to the hottest part of the battle and withdraw from him. He was a good fighter. You could be talented, you could be gifted, but sometimes you need the covering of some other people. When that covering is withdrawn from you, cheaply, the bullet of the enemy will be the best. 2 Samuel chapter 11, 14 and 15. Let me quickly read it. 2 Samuel 11, 14 and 15. And it came to pass in the morning that David wrote a letter to Joab and sent it by the hand of Uriah. And he wrote in the letter saying, set ye Uriah in the forefront of the hottest battle. And do what? Retire ye from him, that he may be smitten and die. And that was what happened. And I discovered that in the battle of life, I need some people to be positioned so that I will not be hit by the bullets of life. If those people withdraw their support, I'm exposed. I'm worried. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, Father, all the people that need to cover me up, all the people that need to support me, so that I'll not be hit by the bullet of my enemy, put them in their rightful position in my life. Let them not withdraw. Let them not withdraw from me. All the people that need to be at some particular point in my life, let them not withdraw from me. Let them not withdraw from me. Thank you, Father. Blessed be you. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Sometimes, the main enemy is not the one that you are fighting with, but the one that is inside that is selling you out. Sometimes the main enemy is not the one you are fighting with, that you know that this one is an enemy, but the one that is inside. David was like an enemy to Uriah. Uriah tried to do everything. He called him. He had already slept with his wife, Bathsheba, and that one had got him pregnant. So he was trying to set David up. Okay, come from the battle. And it was as if this king loved me specially. He does not want me to stress myself. He said, come, go and stay with your wife, so that when they will say she got pregnant, it will be, maybe he came home. He was trying to set him up. He gave him food, but he was an enemy to him. In the book of 2 Samuel chapter 11, 6 to 9, 2 Samuel chapter 11, 6 to 9, David sent to Joab, saying, send me Uriah the Hittite. And Joab sent Uriah to David. And when Uriah was come unto him, David demanded of him how Joab did, and how the people did, and how the war prospered. That was not what he wanted. And David said to Uriah, go down to the house and wash thy feet. And Uriah departed out of the king's house, and there followed him a mess of meat from the king. And Uriah slept at the door of the king's house with all the servants of his lord, and went not down to his house. The plan of the king got frustrated. That was why he now put up plan B. Okay, if he did not go to the house of start to sleep with the wife, and eventually the pregnancy will come, they are like, okay, let me go kill him in the battle. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, every offending friend in my sight, okay, expose and expel. Expose and expel. Every offending friend that is in my sight, Lord, please. Judas. And Judas betrayed him with what?
A kiss.
With a kiss. Anyone that ought not to be among your circle of friends that have been designed to compromise your safety, your success, let the Almighty God expose them. Let the Almighty God expel them. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, deliver me from unfriendly friends. In the name of Jesus, deliver me from the activities of unfriendly friends. Deliver me. Thank you. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Jesus, Son of God. Rise up early.
to sit humbly, to eat the bread of sorrow. For so he giveth his beloved sleep. He died at the age of 50. He planned 150 and he set everything in order. You know, they tested him for 25 years out of the 50 years that he lived. He did not take any step without them advising, this is what you should do, this is how you keep. And his bed has oxygen regulated gadgets so that the air that will be breathing was at age 50. By the time he was dying, his last procession, they breathed life all over the world. About 2.5 million people watched. Until now, they still call it the longest life telecast. But he could not fulfill his target. Except the Lord. You are going to open your mouth and pray and say, Father,
Father,
keep me from evil and keep evil from me. In the name of Jesus. I may be trying by myself, but it's the one that you do that works. Keep evil from me. I cannot be too careful in this life. But it is when you keep me that I'm kept. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. No wonder prophet Jeremiah in the book of Jeremiah chapter 17, verse 14. Jeremiah 17, 14. He said, save me, O Lord, and I'll be saved. Heal me, and I'll be healed. He said to say that it is who God saves that is saved. It is who God heals that is healed. Heal me, O Lord, and I shall be healed. Save me, and what?
I shall be saved.
For thou art my grace. I'd like to say that was the wrong song. Praise the Lord. You are going to open your mouth and pray and say,
Father,
please save me.
Keep
evil away from me. And keep me away from evil. In the name of Jesus. That is when I will say, it's not for me to be trying to say, let me not eat some food. Let me not taste some. Let me not go to some area. Let me not touch any jammer. Save me and I will be saved. Heal me and I will be healed. Touch me and I will be touched. Favor me and I will be favored. Help me and I will be helped. It is vain is the help of man. Intercession with groaning that cannot be uttered. The Holy Spirit is the highest form of prayer. Because what you can never think of praying, He will pray for you. open your mouth and pray and say, Father, as I open my mouth, touch my tongue, grant unto me divine utterance to pray aright concerning the issue of my life, the issue of my family, the issue connected to all my loved ones all over the world. Malikiji Kubalaka Santa Yibidi Baba, Tataka Yibidi Kisipi Libibi, Libidi Kisipi Libibi, the fountain that has stopped will resume the flow. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. And Father, Father, we thank you for these few moments of waiting on you in prayer. Is it not written in your word that your house shall be called the house of prayer? Why? Because your ears are opened unto your own to hearken to their call. Father, more than what we have asked, we that are here and our brethren that are connected to this broadcast, and whatever they are in the world, Father, reach out to us in your mercy. Yeah. Whatever thing that has been programmed for any one of us before now, let all of them never come to pay. Yeah. The good that has not even been programmed, in your mercy, by the reason of what you have done by your spirit, let us start experiencing. Yeah. I cover the lives of these your children here and the ones online with the blood of Jesus. Go and accept.
Amen.
Go and prosper.
Amen.
Go and be saved.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Lord, we commit all these requests that have been dropped because of the week unto your hand. Turn these requests to testimonies.
Amen.
Even the people that are far away because of this time, they can't come and drop their own. Father, answer them all.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying.
Amen.
Let me go down free now.